soldiers patrolled the streets of Dhaka on Saturday as the army imposed a curfew in Bangladesh. The government wants to quell student-led protests that have become increasingly violent and deadly over recent days. Since Thursday, the country's been cut off from the world. Internet and text messaging services have been shut down. But the demonstrations have continued in spite of a ban on public gatherings. Data from hospitals there shows the clashes have killed over 100 people and injured thousands. And with the death toll climbing, the government imposed the national curfew and deployed the military. Students in the South Asian country are angry about controversial quotas for government jobs. They include setting aside 30% of those jobs for the families of those who fought for independence from Pakistan in 1971. The government had scrapped the quota system in 2018 following similar student protests, but a court reinstated it last month. The state appealed against the reinstatement and the Supreme Court suspended it, pending a hearing in August. The protests have also been fueled by high unemployment among young people who make up nearly a fifth of the population. TV channels reported that the curfew was eased for 2 hours on Saturday so people could shop for supplies and get chores done. It will last until 10 a.m. on Sunday, when the government will assess the situation. International rights groups have criticised the internet suspension and the actions of security forces. The European Union has said it is deeply concerned by the violence and deaths.